Morning.
Oh,
there's a little pool there, look at it. Little back pool. They're getting here as well. They come through off the main lake here. Through these reeds. So you might have spotted a lad over there in that swim. There's a couple of lads over
there.
So
I plumb for this swim. Now, most of the fish tend to get in this area of the lake during the day, and they migrate over to here. There's fish here, over here, obviously, but the main way they seem to move around is to get over there. So I'm not really expecting to see any fish over here for a little while. So I'm quite happy to take my time. A lovely tree that I can climb here and get up, and I can look right down into this area. It's only about 2, 3, 4 foot deep. So we're not playing in a lot of water, and as you can see, there's not a lot of space to play a fish. We've got this here and all the rest of it there, but I'm pretty sure we'll be able to hold most of the fish that are in here, except of course those mad little self-bred commons. They will have me in the week, no doubt.
Hobson's choice, no choice. I could go over into that swim there, but it's even more overgrown than this one. Although it's not looking too badly at the moment, it is a lot worse. I've got a bit of space in front of me here, and they do get in here. And after seeing that ghosty in here yesterday, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a good handful of bait right out in front of me there, and another handful just over there. I'm going to put two good handfuls out, and I'm just going to sit back and have some breakfast back there around the other side, and put in a couple of handfuls of bait over to the areas that I see from that swim there. So got sort of a backup choice possibly. We'll see how it goes. It's normally down when you're on your own down here and it's been quiet for a while, you're alright, but like I say, when there's other anglers here, depending on how many rods they're using, whether they're catching, how much noise they make, it can obviously affect your results as well.
Right. What's going on?
Just getting it sorted. I've got all the kit in the swim nicely, but I haven't cast out yet. I put a handful and a half there and a couple of good handfuls out in front of me. I basically, where you've got the weed, the main weed bed, and then you've got those little dotted weed beds, I've just put bait, concentrated bait here and here, and then put a bit of a line. So when they come through that weed bed, they're just going to come across it on every angle that they come at it. Like I say, I don't expect there to be too many fish over here at the moment, if any, because we tend to come over here later in the day. They'll be over, mostly over there at the moment. So what I thought I'd do is I might just take my rod with me over to the other side over there. It's just a short walk. And try a bait in the margin for an hour or so. And just leave these two spots to fizz away, hopefully. But before that, I'm going to have coffee, and I'm going to have a piece of cake. So I'll see you later. Well, I've just nipped round to that swim over there. I'm putting about, well, a good handful, that's for sure. All I've got to do now is drink this coffee. Wait. I could put a few baits out on the left here and put a rod on it, but I want them coming in. I want to see them coming in. I want to gauge their reaction. I want to see how many come in, if any at all. I want to use it as much as anything else as a learning experience, reaffirmation of all the things that I already know, of course. But to be honest with you, on waters like this, sometimes in certain places, certain areas, especially when there's other anglers fishing, etc., etc., you just need to take a little gentle approach and just work your way in carefully. So I know they're going to respond to the bait when they come across it. We'll see how they respond, and then we'll go from there. But I've fished it like this before, and it's worked well, so, you know. I want them basically coming in quite freely and eating the bait is out of caution. And the reason for that is that I'm hoping that the koi will come in and start doing it, and I'm hoping to catch that fish. And it's a little bit like targeting it in a way, and this is the kind of situation where you can actually target a fish. You can actually wait for that fish because you can see it coming in the swim. Well, I'm fishing either spot. I'm going to have to be sitting on the rub, of course, can't leave it. So that's the reason why I've not got two rods out, one in there and one in here. And there's just no room to let a fish run off, basically, because as soon as it does in there or here, it's going to be straight into a mess. So obviously the clutches are going to be set and I have to let the fish run out of the way, of course. But normally when they do, after a while they tend to stop, and if you keep the rod well low, you can bring them back out. But just side strand. That's the plan.
Well, it's 10 o'clock
and already we've got busy coming up just around there. That's also spotted a little bit of fishing coming up around there as well. So, but the one that started there 30, 40 seconds ago, I've got a fish feeding on the spot. Hold on. You can see it quite clearly. There he is. See him? Hold on. There he is. He's moving now. That was probably the fish that was bubbling a few minutes ago. That looked like a... not quite sure how strong this branch is that I found in.
Fish already coming in the swim, having a few, and then nipping off again.
Now, if I've got just a few out there and a hook bait, I might have had that comment. But to be honest with you, I'd rather wait for something a little bit better to come along, which it's bound to do. There's no doubt in my mind that that common has just gone off to get some of its mates. So I expect next time I see that, it will be with somebody else. Hopefully, one of its bigger friends.
There you go, that's what you call a response. Oh, the bloody wind. Shaking the tree around. Look at all that. Loads of bubbling coming up, absolutely loads of it. There's at least one fish back in the swim, scoffing away. I think we're going to have to top up soon. Yeah, it's really going for it. I just caught a glimpse of it, just to the right, there you go, look at all of that coming up, look at it all, look at that, ooh, it's blowing around here, still haven't seen the fish responsible for it though, if it was one of the
koi's I probably would have spotted it by now.
It's sending up clouds actually, I can see the water starting to colour just a little bit. Yeah. So it's another windy Fenland day as you can see. We're getting blown around up here.
I'm glad I'm not up too high.
I think I'm pretty safe though. Not very heavy. I'll just see a nice shape move into the swim.
I can see it just over there actually. Very difficult to spot.
But it's there. Yeah. There's at least one fish coming in. Yeah.
It's obvious when you get fleeting glances of fish, it's difficult to tell how big, whatever. The first one was looked like a mid-double common. And that last one that I just saw coming was a lot bigger.
Yeah,
well, another fish just spotted in the swim, came through and went straight under that weed bed there.
Could be the same common, like I say.
Good to say,
because of the swim. Getting buffeted up here just a tad.
Feels worse than it probably is. bendy old tree. Yeah, but there you go, there's a few bubbles coming up just there.
It's building, isn't it? That's the thing. Like I say, I might have to put a little bit more bait in. What I'll do, obviously, is I'll pick my time. I don't think there's anything in the swim. I've still got to check that spot over there. Swans are in the far corner there. While they're over there, I'm happy to leave this area. I'm going to have to keep an eye on them while I'm away, just in case they nip over. I think this swim's alright at the moment, but it will need topping up at some point.
Well, it's 10:15. I haven't even put a bait out yet. I'm still coming in and out of this little spot here.
Extremely big old kipper down there. This one ain't no double. It's been bubbling away, feeding away. I think it's time to put a rod in. Just want to wait really for it to bugger off and hope that it comes back, but which it probably will. But I think it's the fish that I saw 10, 15, 20 minutes ago coming in. Look at all those bubbles coming up. You know? There it is. Jesus, that's a big old kipper. Whoa, that is a big one. That is a big, big fish. Oh, God, it's right underneath the spit. It's really difficult to spot. Bugger me, that is a big fish. It really is. That is one of the biggest, if not the biggest, in the lake. And it's disappeared now. It's down here. You're not going to be able to see it through the trees. Now, it seems to be feeding. Sort of. You've got these weed beds here. It was this side, but I'm going to put my bait here. And the reason for that is that if it is about, I think there's another fish just... Yeah, there's another fish over that spot there. On the left, just here. It's a big one. There's two of them. Oh, look at the size of that one. I don't know if you're going to be able to pick them out because of the wind and all the rest of it. But there's a couple of real good sized fish out there. Circling over. Oh my word, hold on. Circling over the bait. I can't chuck out a rig while they're there, obviously. Gonna have to wait, so I might as well watch them. That is a bloody big fish there. Oh, look at it going down. It going down and then munching away, and there's nothing I can do about it if it's up. There they go, they're off out. That one in the front there, that one is a whopper. It's a bloody whopper. Right, I'll watch them shoot off. Hopefully they'll go up somewhere there and I can quickly get down, get a bait on and get it out. Hopefully the big one will take the bait, not the little one, but you know, it's that big one's coming back in. Look at him. There's another fish in there already. There's a number of fish in there. It's gone a little bit wild all of a sudden. I knew it would. Oh my word. Across the back of that fish, and the length. They're really stirring the water up now. They're really getting into it. Look at them getting into it, scoffing away. They love it. This is as much fun as catching them. Come on, it really, really is. Sitting up the tree, watching it. Look at that. Now you can get it. Look at that thing. I think that that's the big common. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the big common. Comes in at upper 20s, low 30s.
Right.
Let's get down from this tree, get the rod sorted out, get back up the tree, check the swim, and see if we can get a rig out. That big common's just been back in again.
He's just scooted off to the right. There he is. Down there. I think he might be coming round for another pass. Oh, he's turned left again. He's going through that gap there. Right, this is my chance to get a bait in.
Right, bait's out. I've just seen the koi circle and go down on the right hand spot of bait. Spread out, so it's feeding on it.
Yeah, we're in with a chance.
Having it.
See bubbles coming up.
Well, I've taken the rod out.
I haven't had a look in the swim yet. I'm just going to
get a bite to eat. I'm absolutely starving. I need to just sit down somewhere comfortable.
A little bit quiet. Really getting battered there. Really getting battered. Oh, something like a sandwich. Cheese and cucumber sandwiches today. There's no tomatoes left in the house. I don't need them. So, I'm going to get back up the tree. Have a look-see. I'll put another handful of bait out. And I'm going to move my rod from the left further out, where it's a little bit deeper, and maybe I can get a bite. When I pulled the rig out, it felt fine, so I think it was probably sitting properly. I was just sussing it. It's literally only a couple of feet there, so yeah. They're all in here. Let's have a sandwich quickly and get up the tree. You're probably wondering why I'm taking my time and all the rest of it, and get two rods on it or whatever, but experience has taught me that situations like this, they can actually be difficult to catch the fish from, even though they're coming in scoffing it. In shallow water, that's the problem. I need to move that bait slightly deeper water further out. The other thing, of course, is I have caught a lot of carp. It's like I'm not desperate all the time to catch, in the sense that I'm going to throw everything else aside. I'm not going to miss a chance of being up the tree and watching them like this. You know. Cucumber and cheese. Nice. I just filled the spot. I need a mat of coffee as well, so I'm going to mat of coffee. And I'm going to get up the tree. It's noticeable, you know, when I tossed out that bait, the common was about 4 or 5 metres away on the other side of the big weed bed, swimming to the right. And it boiled when that lead hit the water, and it only went slight plop and it only got a 1 ounce lead on. I think it moved. It wouldn't surprise me if I get up a tree and I don't see it. Right. Let's get the kettle on, make a coffee.
Right, well, been up the tree, and the three fish coming in, and as far as I can tell, they are the three biggest fish that I've seen in this lake. One's common, one's a fully scale, and one's a mirror, and the koi as well, that's coming in. But these three, they're all big 20s at least. So, obviously putting it to the left there isn't working out for me, so I'm going to put it in the deeper water further out to the right. Anywhere you put it here is going to be risky, in the sense of need to put the bait where I'm going to get the bite. So that's what I'm going to do. But I'm going to bag up as well, because I don't want to go chucking in bait. I'm thinking, I just want one plop. Bag does make a bit of a plop, unfortunately. But there's
not a lot I can do. I need to get that bait in. I need to know that it's down properly. I need to know that there's some bait around it. So it'll be up the tree, and as soon as I'm certain, I'll come down and I'll toss this out. You can never be 100% certain, because I'm trying to keep track of them. But if you can spot them all together, and you see them all disappear, then that can be a good indication, a good time to...
But like I say, you want as far away really as possible, because they listen out for it, you know? So my usual bag, which is four boilies finely crumbed around a hook bait, and then four more boilies roughly coarsely chopped on top of that, and then four whole boilies on top of that. 12 boilies all told, and then just basically now what I do is squeeze the boilies down, lick the top of that, just seal it, lick the tab, pull it over, squeeze the boilies again, lick that, a couple of turns, oh, it's just nicking. Cut the corners off, that's it. Get that out, shall we? First of all, let's get up the tree and have a look see.
Okay, so I can't see anything at the moment, but we'll stay up here for a while. Often don't see them, just see the bubbles, they can nip in without you knowing. I think they've had a lot of the bait though. That's the area, just there, where I wanted the bait, and that's where I've had it.
Really getting difficult to bloody see anything now.
Doesn't look like there's anything around, so might be a good time to toss that bait out. Right, here goes nothing. Just stick that camera. Right, let's get that.
Well, I keep changing the position of the camera, trying to get good light for you, but it's not easy.
Epic!
In the net. Sorry I didn't get it on film, but it went so hard.
Let's have a look, shall we? Well, sadly, it's not one of the ones that I was after, but it is a nice mirror after all. Just went. No big deal, just went. Rod just... There we go.
Rock time. Well, hopefully the wind will stay quiet enough for you to have able to hear me, because it's just been roaring, hasn't it? I'll get a bit closer to the camera. So unfortunately we didn't get one of the four, we did get one of the others though.
So that's a start.
And it's a lovely fish, but really actually, it's an amazing looking mirror. Check out the colours on this fish. Look at that.
fresh and lively. I didn't mess around with it, it got right under the weed, but just kept the rod low. Applied pressure and eventually it came back in. There you go, look at that. That's a sweetheart, isn't it? 18 pounds. When I first got it on, I saw it come over on the surface, I thought I got one of the big, I got the big mirror, but it did power off a little bit too quick for a big one. Right, just slip this baby back, get some more bait out. Come break first. Right. We'll slip it in at the back here, eh? Oh, it takes it out here, I tell you. Concentration. You just feel the intense sort of pressure all the time. Man, any second that rod's just going to do what it did there. Around. What's the trouble with the littler ones? They will tear off like that. The bigger ones, they'll give you a few bleeps first. A bit slower.
Right, well the camera's on charge at the moment and I'm going to leave it on charge for a little while. I'm ready for round two though. I'm all bagged up again and I've got a pocket full of bait. We'll see what we get, eh? I'll let you know how it goes on. But I just want to leave this camera on charge for a little while. And the constant pressure, I need to relax a little bit and just switch the camera off and not worry too much about anything and just, you know. We could get another one, and we might get one of those ones that came in this morning, but let's face it, we've had a great day so far and we've learned so much and we've seen so much too, so, yeah.
See, as soon as your back is turned, they're right on you, they were right on me. Bloody things, aren't they? Still howling, hold on. This camera's a bit wonky, but there's not a lot I can do about it. The wind is absolutely howling with this thing here. Occasionally it just swings and comes straight up. See, this wind is really hammering in. Thank you. That was pretty frantic. One of the little commons. It's this wind, it's just blowing the hell out of me, you know? I just wish it quietened down, I really do. Right, I'll just get it on the mat and show you it, and then we'll quickly pop it back. Maybe we should stay a bit longer, I don't know. There he is. That's the little devil, there's a few of them in here. But look at them, they're absolute minters. You know? Absolute minters. Ooh. They say work is hard. This wind is just blowing. Oh, it's incessant noise. It's just getting blown over sometimes, literally. So that was a bit unexpected, but then again, to be expected. I think them big ones have definitely moved on. Yeah, so I think we'll call it a day. I've got to get home and get a few things done. That's the beauty of short day sessions, though. You know, if you're strict about it, you can have a life. You know, you can get things sorted and you can go fishing. When I was doing like 2-3 nights a week, nothing was getting done. Everything was getting left. And that's not good, so. Well, I'm happy, I've had a couple. I think probably all we'll get now is a little one, so maybe we'll come back tomorrow morning, you never know. I might go elsewhere, see how I feel. But for the time being, I think we've had a successful session. Certainly been a lot of fun.